Hey guys, here's where we're at today. We're kind of all mixed up. We switched the planter over to soybeans for a couple of days, and we ended up getting rain for one of those days. But we got going on corn again yesterday, so now we got some bean ground that we gotta spray and get the land roller going on. And we also have a lot of ground for the corn that isn't tilled yet. So what we're doing this morning is Dad is out running the field cultivator. I'm gonna take the iPad out with the rock picker and head up to a field I was in yesterday planting. I marked some rocks that we need to go back and get. So I'm gonna head up and grab some of those rocks, then I'm gonna come back here and put a new hydraulic filter on this thing because it was flashing at me telling me that the hydraulic filter isn't flowing enough. So we'll get a new filter on that and throw some seed corn in there, and then we'll be on our way for the day, hopefully get some acres in. So when I'm planting, I can actually just drop one of those pins and I can drive right back here with the rock picker and come and grab it. Okay, the rocks are picked. We got a quick minor change in plans here. We only had one hydraulic filter on the shelf, so I gotta run to town and grab a second one because that specific tractor takes two of them. So I'm gonna head to Glenwood to Midwest Machinery and grab a second filter quick while Jim yanks those ones off. I'm thinking the state patrol wouldn't exactly be fond of me having that hanging 40 feet out the back of the pickup. Okay, the hydraulic filters are changed. Sorry I didn't get it on video. Jim had it handled and didn't seem like he wanted a camera in his face. Now I'm gonna take the planter out. We're gonna back it up to the conveyor and throw a few bags of seed in here. We're gonna have a few bags to throw around today because we're running some more tests with some different hybrids.
Well, this thing don't have to be in there, does it?
Nope. Which one?
It's got to be in the bottom, the very end.
Yeah, this one right here. Yeah.
Don't need a main big bolt.
They're all 3/4?
It must be. That's it.
Oh, yeah, that would work, but I didn't.
That one's bent?
Yeah, yeah.
You don't think this the housing would be bent, is it?
I wonder.
It'd have to be this, wouldn't it?
Yeah, and I don't think that is. I think that fell off because it hit something and bent.
If it's not leaving a ridge, I'd leave it. Finally, let's go get some corn planted. I've got about 2 acres left of this field. You can see here the mud we're dealing with. This area is not usually this wet like this, so it's kind of been a struggle. We believe, and a lot of local guys believe, that the frost is still coming out of the ground here. This stuff shouldn't be quite this wet, but you try to get what you can with the planter so that you're not leaving too many acres fallow or unplanted. But at some point you just got to leave it and get out of there. because you end up plugging these row units with mud like I did last week, or I've done several times this week. But here we go again, more of this. Okay, so the big issue that happens here is that this gumbo mud, this stuff, gets up inside here, inside the gauge wheel, and then it rubs against the openers here. The gauge wheel and these openers control the seed trench and the depth, so if you've got mud that's this sticky inside there, it just doesn't let anything spin free. You end up with a pretty bad placement on your seed. Just a minor annoying setback. Hopefully I've learned my lesson for the day. Okay, 50 acres finished up that field. You can see the next field getting ready here. Jim's out in the digger, the field cultivator, getting this ready. And the third field for the day to finish our corn is not ready yet either. So I'm gonna head home and take the land roller out for a bit. So now it's time for me to take the land roller out and roll some of that soybean ground we got planted yesterday. And man, is it hot out.
The nicest field conditions that they've ever planted in. So we're setting up right now a very good planting pace, good planting condition.
I'm driving 9 miles an hour and this tractor's a little bit shaky and I don't have a good magnetic spot to put the camera in here, so I apologize for the shaky video. But why do we do this? Well, we do this only on our soybean ground because we're trying to push down the old root clumps from last year's corn crop, and we also want to push down all the little stones that are left that are unpicked, because when we come by to harvest this, the bean headers run right on the ground when we're harvesting. And so the more level the ground is, the better we can get right down to the ground and get the pods off the beans. So a good level ground for bean harvest is critical to get as many of the pods as you can possibly get. So that's kind of the main reason that we do this. The reason we don't do it on corn, the big reason is because we really don't need to get right down under the ground when we're harvesting corn. We don't need to worry about picking up rocks with the corn header for the most part. If you do, you got other problems, but for the most part, the little rocks are not a big issue. Also, where we've planted most of the corn, there's not this last year's corn stalk residue on the ground. So the ground is a lot blacker. There's a lot less stubble or residue or trash, whatever you want to call it, lying on top of that ground. And the wind, when the thunderstorms come through this time of year, and even during early summer before the crop is out, can blow the sand around, and we don't want that sand to blow out. We want it to stay in our fields. And not only do we want it in the fields because that's our best dirt, we also want it in the fields because if it whips around from the wind, it'll actually start cutting some of those corn leaves. There's a rock right there that I missed. Roll over it nice and gentle and push it down a little bit, and it'll be out of the way. Actually, I might jump out and carry that one to the fence line, but anyway, the wind and the sand blowing around is hard on the corn crop also, so if you don't roll the corn fields, you don't get near as much of that happening. So that's the reason we only do beans. There's the boss digging out one final rock for us. Or at least one final rock on this field for today. Not the last rock ever, I'm guessing. In less than a mile, I got two tractors behind me, a tractor underneath me, and two tractors in front of me. There are tractors everywhere. Okay, we got the 80 acres rolled. You can see we dumped a little bit of the corn out of the one side of the planter because that's the wrong maturity for what we want for the field we're going to. So we dumped that out. We're going to be putting that back in later, but for now we're going to put in some shorter maturity corn. Crisis handled. Back to the cornfields. Love this time of night. To a field right now of what we call corn on corn, meaning it was corn last year and it's corn this year. So as far as what I've done differently is I've bumped up the down pressure a little bit just to push more weight down onto those row units to push them through the old corn stalks. And I did boost the population of what I'm planting just a little bit because I think we'll have a little bit less germination here just because it is harder or more difficult to plant through some of that residue. So hopefully I can get this in tonight, at least half this field. I've got 15 acres of it in now. I'd like to get at least 70 of this done tonight before I quit. And then I'm hoping we can finish corn tomorrow. We would have about 50 to 60 acres of this field left, and then a 30 acre test plot that's gonna take a little while to finish. But there's rain coming tomorrow night the way it sounds. So I'd really like to get that finished tomorrow, get done with corn, move on full time to beans, and continue planting. It is quite peaceful out here at night. All right, it's 11 o'clock and I'm out of fuel. I didn't get this whole thing planted. I got about three good long rounds left yet. But I don't really dare push it any farther on fuel, especially this time of night. I don't want to have to call anybody and have them come get me. So I'm going to run this thing home. I'm not too far from home anyway. And throw it in the shed. We'll refuel it in the morning and be back at it. Well, this is a first. That winglet right there is stuck like that, halfway up, halfway down. So I can't fold the planter up and I'm about out of diesel. So I got Dad coming to get me right now. We're just gonna leave this thing sit on the edge of the field tonight, see what we got in the morning. It's always something. Thanks for watching, guys.